getting broke, yeah. Makes all young. Yeah.
Made my bed and I dug my grave. You don't worry what the fuck I say. I saw God through 008, been getting wilder, yeah, to this day. I got no shame in my face. I read threats and I give thanks. And she aiming whatever it take on my name. That's my game. All day going psycho, on top of the Kiko. Man just trying to go to psycho. You just trying to go viral. You trying to build you up an empire. Digging more, you won't revive us. No, dust in the wind, let it blow away. Sun comes out, all the stars gotta go away.
All my heavy chains getting broken. And my weary heart's giving hope. Come exalt the young man.
Oh snap! Another one?
I can ask him.
Yeah. Oh yeah, let's see it. Let's, yeah.
We're gonna ask you about the. We're all just gonna ask you four, and you're gonna tell me if you've broken them or not.
Yeah.
And we're not judging.
Yeah, of course.
This
yeah.
Is like what?
Of course.
So, thou shall not commit adultery.
Well, I'm not married, so what's the strictest definition of adultery?
Looking at a woman
or man
with lust.
Yeah, of course. Okay. Absolutely.
And then thou shalt not steal if you're stolen anything.
Absolutely.
Okay. And thou shalt not lie.
Definitely
lie. Okay. And then what was the covet? Is it that was one of
coveting
them?
Coveting
your wife.
You're not or yeah, your or your neighbor's belongings.
Like the first question, but yeah, sure, I'm guilty of all four of those.
Yeah. Okay. So according to the Bible you're a bad person.
Am I a bad person or am I a sinner that could be redeemed?
Wait, am I wrong?
No.
I might be wrong. This, but they just asked me this.
Okay.
I'm not a part of it. I just walked up and.
Oh, you're not part of this.
Yeah. Well, I am.
You're like me. You just stumbled upon this.
Yeah.
Dude, he picked it up so fast like that.
So are you part of this?
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
So
I'm
a bad person.
No, according to the Word of God, by God's standard of judgment, which is the Ten Commandments, the Ten Commandments of the tribe of Israel.
Yeah.
In the Old Testament.
Sure.
The Ten Commandments. That's what he was just asking. There's ten of them.
Yeah.
Four of them. So by yourself, you just admitted that you're lying, liar, thieving, murderous.
Well, you
no, not
murder.
Murderous.
Yeah,
murderous.
I
adult murder.
Murder.
Not murderous.
No murder.
Now, this is the murderous part.
Or so you may think.
Hated someone. The Bible says you ever hated a brother.
Sure.
You committed murder in your heart.
In my heart.
Yeah. Just like lust.
Okay.
So if God, if there is a God, which I believe there is, you don't believe there's a God.
No.
Which I can prove to you in 1 minute.
Okay.
Scientifically, there's scientific evidence that there's God. That tree there.
I think there's a designer, so our DNA is
100%.
Coded. Is coded, right? Like a genetic code.
Yes, absolutely.
But, all right, does that indicate a God, or does it indicate maybe possibly
absolutely.
Like an alien creator?
Absolutely.
We are created by aliens. Does it have to be the God? Does it have to be a God like you're saying, like a biblical
there's,
God? Then whose God?
No.
Is it the Christian God?
No,
is it
the God
Muslim
of the universe.
God?
The God, the creator of all things.
The Hindu gods, so you just think they're all the same god. Like the
Hindus believe somebody had made the aliens. Somebody had made
that,
the aliens.
That's always
that
the counterpoint. That's always the counterpoint.
If there's such a thing.
That's always the counterpoint. Who created the aliens? It's true.
I don't believe there's aliens.
Okay.
I believe the Word of God. I believe the Bible. And the Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens.
You believe it?
Yeah.
You ever heard of Psalm, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament showeth his handiwork? Day unto day he uttereth speech, and night unto night showeth knowledge. There is no speech nor language where his voice is not heard. His line goes out through all the earth, and his voice to the ends of the earth. Okay? So his end of the age. I'm sorry, I messed up the end. But anyway, all creation points to God. People can see that they're repentant. So all creation, people have no excuse. It says in the book of Romans that they are without excuse.
Yeah.
That to see their sinfulness and in need of a Savior. People have no excuse. So we talked earlier about God's law, the moral law, the Ten Commandments.
Yeah.
So if God is there, if God is true, which I believe he is, and I know he is, and you believe that there's a designer. Okay,
we
so
do.
If God is true and he's gonna judge you by those commandments,
yeah,
that I are you gonna be innocent or guilty?
Guilty.
Does that concern you?
I mean, it doesn't concern me because I don't believe
it
in
concerns
God.
Us. That's why we're out here telling people.
Let me tell you one more thing. So if I believe, actually, if I believe I actually think that it would be easy to
believe what? Believe what? I don't know if our belief is the same.
No, I'm gonna say if I believed in God, I actually think that it would be easy not to sin. You know why? Because this is a grain of sand in infinity. So if you were to go to heaven and you live in heaven forever, like infinity, you can't comprehend infinity compared to like, you know, our 80 years here on earth. But nothing here would tempt me? A nice car, a nice woman. None of that stuff would tempt me because it's irrelevant. Like, you're talking about infinity in heaven versus
80
years on earth.
Good point.
Like,
but people still fight with...
So because I don't think they really believe. And the other thing, I
struggle with things. Let me say this world, the flesh, and the devil. Those are the three things that we're tempted with on this planet. The Bible says it. The world, the flesh, and the devil. Mm-hmm. World power, the flesh. Yeah. We want wealth. We want lust after women, right? Yeah. And then the devil. The devil tempts us to do things that are wrong against God's spirit. So he does tempt us with the world, flesh, and devil. Yeah. And even me as a Christian, I've accepted Christ. I've accepted his payment.
Yeah.
I accepted what he's done on the cross of Calvary.
Yeah.
He's satisfied the wrath of God that should have been poured out on me.
Yeah.
I lied. I stole. I lust after women. But Jesus Christ lived the life I couldn't live. He came down. God became human.
Yeah.
He became human flesh. Yeah. He lived the perfect life.
Yeah.
And he died. He didn't need to die. The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death. I die because I deserve it.
Yeah.
He died. He didn't deserve it. He never sinned
But
once.
Even he has a moment of weakness. He's on the cross, and he's on his moment of weakness. He's like, God, help me. He cries out to him.
Father, into your hands I commit my spirit.
He said,
my God, why have you forsaken me?
Yeah, there we go.
Quoting what? So, Psalm 22,
He was
right?
The only man in all of history that was forsaken by God. God forsook him.
Yeah.
Right?
Separated.
That was his whole mission. So I feel like even he had a moment of weakness.
In a way, he was weak.
The
was
one
human.
Who knew no sin became sin for us.
Yes.
He literally stood. He stood in the way, and he bore the wrath of God.
Yeah.
All those sins that we've committed, by your grandparents, mom, dad, nephew, niece, whoever it is, God paid for the sins of the world.
Yeah.
With his own life's blood. That's why, for God so loved the world. Now you hear that verse all the time.
Sure.
But when you hear the phrase God loves you or God loves us, you have to understand why. You know, we didn't deserve this sacrifice of Jesus Christ. We didn't deserve his mercy.
But I think we do deserve it because he created us. It's his
fault we're here. You know what we do deserve?
Well, he gave us
Hell,
he gave us life, and he just asked us, keep these things. Don't sin against me.